In this screencast, we're going to look at operating a batch distillation unit with a constant reflux ratio. In the problem statement, we're given the total number of equilibrium stages in the system, 2. We're also given a reflux ratio of 3. And then we're posed with the scenario that at the distillate composition is 60 mole percent. We know how much is in the reboiler in terms of number of moles. And then we're asked to determine the amount of liquid left in the reboiler when the instantaneous distillate composition is a later value of 50 mole percent. So let's take a second to think about what this distillation unit looks like. Early simple distillation units consist of just a pot still with a condenser to get the distillate product out. In this case, we're not looking at that. We're actually thinking about taking this basic reboiler system and adding an additional column to the top of that. So we have reflux returning to the column, and we have additional equilibrium stages associated with that. And in this operation, we have the Rayleigh equation to relate the compositions and the amounts of materials in the still at any given time. So our overall plan is to first find a relationship between the distillate and the reboiler compositions, and we're going to do that by constructing a McCabe-Thiele diagram. And then we're going to take that information and plug that into a numerical integration of the Rayleigh equation. And for this situation, we're going to use the Simpson's rule to do that numerical integration. So first, in order to get started with the McCabe-Thiele diagrams, we're going to first find vapor-liquid equilibrium data, and we have some provided here for the ethanol-water system. And then on that diagram, we're going to zoom in to the region of interest and also plot our operating line. Our operating line for this case is going to be bound by the point x is equal to y is equal to our distillate composition of 0.5, so we've plotted that point here. And we also know we have a reflux ratio of 3, and from that we calculate a slope of 3/4 for our operating line. When we plot that operating line, we can then step off 2 stages and determine when we have a distillate composition of 0.5, which is our endpoint in our distillation operation, we know that the composition in the reboiler is 4% ethanol. So now we have a relationship between x sub d and x sub w at the end of our process. Now we need to repeat this to relate x sub d and x sub w both at the beginning of the process and also at one point directly in the middle. We're going to talk about why we chose those points a little later when we get into the details of the Simpson's rule. So if we pick the point in the middle and start evaluating the relationship between x sub d and x sub w, we repeat the same process. Since our reflux ratio is constant, we still have the same slope of an operating line. But now, since we have a new distillate composition of 55 mole percent ethanol, we now have translated that line further up that x equals y reference line. So now we step off 2 stages and see that when we have a distillate composition of 55 mole percent ethanol, we have a reboiler concentration, or an x sub w, of 6% ethanol. Repeat the process one more time. And now we're evaluating at the beginning of our distillation process, where we have a distillate composition of 60 mole percent ethanol, and we see that's related to a reboiler composition of 9% ethanol. Now we just simply tabulate the results we've generated so far, and I've shown that here with one column indicating our reboiler compositions of x sub w, and then one column indicating our distillate compositions x sub d. So now that we've related the distillate and the reboiler compositions, now we want to return to our original problem statement using the Rayleigh equation, and we want to take this equation and we want to evaluate this side of the equation, the right-hand side of the equation, using the Simpson's rule, which is a numerical integration technique. Now the Simpson's rule just takes a look at the function that's inside the integral and evaluates that function at 3 different points, which would be the initial point, the final point, and a point directly in between. For our case, we actually have a function of 1 over x sub d minus x sub w. So now we simply have to evaluate this f of x at 3 different points in the distillation operation. So let's go back to Excel to do that, and what we see here is I've created a new column in Excel that simply takes 1 divided by the distillate composition minus the reboiler composition, our x sub w, and calculates that for each of these 3 points. Once we have that, we then create a new cell, which I'm calling the Simpson's rule sum here, And basically, I've entered the formula for Simpson's rule, which is our final reboiler composition minus the initial reboiler composition divided by 6, plus our initial state, plus 4 times our halfway point, plus the final state. And when we evaluate that term, we now have an approximation for the right-hand side of the Rayleigh equation. So when we go back, we now have this right-hand side of the Rayleigh equation, and we can then just do the simple math using our initial charge to the reboiler and calculate the final number of moles in that reboiler. I've done so here in Excel, where the final amount of material in the reboiler is related to the initial number of moles in the reboiler, times e to the negative sum that we determined by the Simpson's rule. And when we evaluate that, we see the final number of moles in the reboiler is 677 moles.